This is Dave Tate with a special edition of Table Talk. This is a special edition because this is filmed outside of the order of all the other Table Talks that I've already done that are waiting and archived to be published. The reason I'm doing this one is instead of doing a social media tip of the week, I decided just to knock out this question from Adam instead. So Adam's got a two-part question here. And the first part is, on a technical level, what is the favorite training template that I've ever used, or the scheme or method? And with that, it should be pretty cut and dry that for me, for strength, it's a concurrent or a conjugated type of training system. I personally feel that when done properly, that's the best training system that you can use for strength. It's the best way to focus on all the aspects of strength development, from the maximal strength to hypertrophy to explosive strength. It trains and it includes all aspects of that, as well as focusing and bringing up and helping to determine what your weak points are. It can be modified to suit anybody's needs based upon, you know, their strength or their weaknesses, or however or wherever the focus needs to be. If it's a competitive schedule or if it's just a general strength training schedule, it can be modified for more hypertrophy if that's what you're looking for, or more strength. From a pure hypertrophy standpoint, my answer would be different. I think just more of a classic bodybuilding protocol with higher volume is going to be a better way to go, but you're going to sacrifice strength development in the process. So from a sporting standpoint, more of the concurrent conjugated standpoint, from a powerlifting, obviously that standpoint, from a bodybuilding, then more of a typical training protocol. But it's all based upon the individual needs, time restraints, and training age. The second part of the question involves training kids. There's a Adam's asking about two 16-year-old cousins, which pretty much spend most of their time playing video games, sitting on the couch, pretty much what a lot of people would consider your average kid, you know, in America. And they're expressing interest in weightlifting, but at the same time, they can't do 20 push-ups. They can't hold a static squat. I'm sure there's a whole host of other body weight type movements that they can't do as well. They happen to be family, which puts another wrench in the equation. They're not sons. They're relatives, but it still puts a wrench in the equation. And wondering what my advice is for training them without them getting bored. And what I'm not seeing here, Adam, is how you're going to do this without compromising your own training as well, because there is a trade out that needs to be considered and factored into this. For all of us who are asked to help with programming or help to train somebody else, be it youth or a friend or relative or not, there's always an opportunity cost associated with each one of these things in that need to be factored in. You know, if you're going to work with these kids, can they do or be in the gym at the same time that you are without negatively affecting your own training? Because if not, that means you're going to have to train them at a different time, or your workout time that you're in the gym now is going to be extended. So there is a certain opportunity cost, like I said, that needs to be factored in to this. They are expressing interest, which is a good thing. You know, so that should be a major consideration whenever anybody's working or considering working with any kids. They need to want to do it. If they don't want to do it, then I personally, from my standpoint, I wouldn't have them do that. It's a delicate balance when you're working with kids, because you want to see them embrace, you know, what we love so much, but it may not be their passion. So you don't want to burn them out or have them end up hating something that they really should make a part of their life forever. You know, exercise, not just weightlifting, weight training, powerlifting, or whatever they're going to get into or may not get into. Exercise has to be a part of their life. So the last thing that we want to do is to just destroy that and have them not ever want to go into the gym. What should they do? I mean, if they're that deconditioned, you know, I would have them come into the gym and watch you train and see how that goes. You know, have them do maybe a couple things just to see what their interest is, and nothing major, nothing like deadlifts, or just, I would stay with body weight movements. I would, however, you know, they can't do 20 push-ups. So I would reinforce that with them, that they have to build strength, you know, with their own body weight before they can start using external resistance, because, you know, it goes along with the game. You know, if they can't do a push-up, then they have no business doing bench presses. So I'd have them do the body weight movements, but at the same time, in sled dragging, I mean, all the basic stuff, all the basic conditioning stuff that you would have anybody else do that came into the gym deconditioned is what you're going to basically want to have them do. But what I would watch more so than anything else is how they interact, if they're having fun, if they're not having fun, and then I would throw more stuff in if they are having fun with it, and I would pull stuff out if they're not having fun with it, or I'd have them come in fewer times. You know, start out with once a week, see how that goes, and then work it up from there. It's a simple question to answer. I mean, we all know it's going to be body weight movements, but you made a very, very clear point here, is how are you going to do this without them getting bored? You know, when they're in a gym and they're seeing you getting after it and you're doing the squats and the pulls and you're doing all the heavy training, you know, they're going to want to be a part of that. So somehow or another, you got to find a way to make them a part of that, to feel a part of that, to get that connection, so they're going to want to come back, even if it's you know, loading bars or pointing things out to them while the other lifters are lifting, you know, showing them, you know, look at how John keeps his back arched, see how Steve's pushing his knees out, you know, point out what the technical things that the other lifters are doing right and that they're not doing right, so they feel a part and they feel connected of what's going on. That would be the best advice I would give to them, or to you, as far as that goes.